I walked through a county courthouse square. On a park bench, an old man was sitting there. I said, "Your old courthouse is kind of run down." He said, "No, it'll do for our little town." I said, "Your old flagpole has leaned a little bit, and that's a ragged old flag you got hanging on it." He said, "Have a seat." And I sat down. "Is this the first time you've been to our little town?" I said, "I think it is." He said, "I don't like to brag, but we're kind of proud of that ragged old flag. You see, we got a little hole in that flag there when Washington took it across the Delaware. And it got powder burned the night that Francis Scott Key sat watching it write and say, 'Can you see?' And it got a bad rip in New Orleans with Pakenham and Jackson tugging at its seams. And it almost fell at the Alamo beside the Texas flag, but she waved on, though. She got cut with a sword at Chancellorsville, and she got cut again at Shiloh Hill. There was Robert E. Lee, Beauregard, and Bragg, and the south wind blew hard on that ragged old flag. On Flanders Field in World War I, she got a big hole from a Bertha gun. She turned blood red in World War II. She hung limp and low a time or two. She was in Korea, Vietnam. She went where she was sent by her Uncle Sam. She waved from our ships upon the briny foam, and now they've about quit waving back here at home. In her own good land here, she's been abused. She's been burned, dishonored, denied, and refused. And the government for which she stands is scandalized throughout the land. And she's getting threadbare and she's wearing thin, but she's in good shape for the shape she's in. Cause she's been through the fire before, and I believe she can take a whole lot more. So we raise her up every morning, we take her down every night, we don't let her touch the ground, and we fold her upright. On second thought, I do like to brag, cause I'm mighty proud of that ragged old flag.
Our son was born so long ago, yet it seems like yesterday that I stood in awe before his crib and heard that doctor say, "You've quite a boy there, Mr. Jones." I could only answer with a nod, for in his very being there, I saw the miracle of God. Later, in his high chair, in a manner I deplore, I saw the miracle of God throw his oatmeal on the floor. Well, I fixed him something different. I felt he must be fed, but when I turned around again, that bowl was on his head. A few more years rolled along, and he didn't spill things anymore. But his granddad sent a big bass drum, and once more I deplored the fact that my miracle of God had a lusty taste for noise. When he'd boom, boom, boom on that big bass drum, I questioned, boys must be boys. I asked his whereabouts one day. His mom said he's got a paper route, said he'd helped earn his way as he became an Eagle Scout. When they pinned that medal on him, tears welled in my eyes, and then I gripped his mother's hand. Our boy had earned his prize. I won't forget that September day when he entered senior high. He had an air of great excitement, but he left home with a sigh. He came back that afternoon and gave us some puzzled looks. "Wow," he said, "this school is tough. Look at all these books." Choice is yours, his mother said. You can pick the easy way. What you put into life, you'll get out of it. Each man pays his price one day. He looked up, and then he smiled. I saw he'd lost his gloom. He said, I better look at these. He headed for his room. My son came home late one day. He seemed all worn out. I asked a little sharply what this was all about. He spoke proudly and threw his shoulders back. And in his eyes, I caught a gleam. I wanted to surprise you, Dad. I'm on the football team. They won most of their games, lost a few. It was a thrill to watch him play. When they didn't win, we knew he'd met the challenge anyway. He didn't know it at the time, but it was a stepping stone. Solid footing for the climb to face life on his own. How those 3 years flew past. When graduation came, we saw our boy grown up at last. Our lives will never be the same. I guess we've known all along what his goal would be. From that time 3 years ago when he chose responsibility. He stood in the doorway yesterday, put out a strong right hand.